Hi, my name is Vijay Kumar Chauhan and we are here to talk about log splitting. We all know that logs comes at a cost. Why? Because it reduces the amount of parallelism. But can we seriously blame the logs for them? Actually, no. It is not the logs but contention of logs which is the root cause. And what is that? It is a condition where one thread is waiting for a log that is currently being held by another thread. But this seems like an inevitable situation while using logs. Actually, no. Let's take an example to understand the performance impact logs have on a multi-threaded application and what we can do about it. So let's design a game of poker. The rules are pretty simple. We have multiple tables in the casino and each table has maximum number of players that the table can accommodate. For example, let's say 9. And the most important rule, the table has a minimum limit. That is, the player who wishes to join the table must possess money which is greater than table's minimum limit. Straightforward. Now let's design the game. We have the game server. It has multiple methods like join, leave, create table and destroy table. For demonstration purpose, let's go into details of join method. It is a synchronized method which takes into arguments, player and table. First we check the player's balance. If it is greater than the table's limit, we get the list of players who are currently seated on that particular table, and if that list is less than 9, we simply add a player into that list. The join method does its job, but it is not really efficient. Why? Because there is one simple option which we can do. We can first check the money possessed by the player and then acquire the log. So the revised version of join method looks something like this. Instead of making the join method as synchronized, what we have done is we have acquired the tables using the synchronized block, and that too in a condition. So we check the balance first and then we acquire the logs on tables. But is this the best that we can do? So probably think about it. Can we do better? And of course, the answer is yes. And the technique is called log splitting. So what was the problem? The problem is we don't need the tables after a certain point of time. So let's take this for example. We get the tables players by locking the tables object, but after that we do not acquire the tables. So what do? We release the lock and we try to acquire another log which is tables players, that is the list of players seated on a particular table. So what we have just done, we have split a log into two. One, the tables log, and the other, the table players logs. So this is called log splitting. So in a nutshell, what is log splitting? It is about using different logs for different parts of the functionality. And what is the advantage? We reduce the likelihood of logs becoming contended, which was actually a root cause. So hope this video was helpful to understanding what log splitting is all about. Thank you. If you like the video, kindly share with your friends. Thank you.